Hello and welcome to this session. Now in level 1 under topic similarity and transformation, we have discussed the various types of transformations, translation, reflection, rotation and dilation. In this session we'll see that the transformation acts as a function that takes points in the plane as input and give other points as output. Now let us recall the three types of transformations. Now, translation moves the object so that every point on the object moves in same direction at same distance. Here only the object slides, shape and size remain same. Now, this figure represents translation of image. Here every point has moved in same direction and at same distance. Now let us see what is a rotation. Now rotation is a transformation in which the object is rotated about a fixed point. The direction of rotation can be clockwise or anti-clockwise, and here also shape and size remain same, that is shape and size of the figure remain same. Now here you can see this figure represents rotation of image about center of rotation A, that is the point A, by some angle. Now let us see the third type of transformation, which is reflection. Now in reflection, an object is flipped across a line of reflection, so shape and size remain same. Now this figure represents a reflection of image in vertical axis. The image is flipped in the line of reflection. Now let us discuss transformation as a function. Now transformation is an operation that moves, flips or changes a figure to create a new figure, and here the new figure created by a transformation is called image, and original figure is called the pre-image. Now if the pre-image is given by A, then its image will be given by A dash, and image of A dash will be given by A double dash. Now a transformation is one-to-one correspondence between two sets of points A and A dash, such that every point in set A corresponds to only one point in set A dash called its image, and every point in set A dash is image of one and only one point in set A called its pre-image. Thus, a transformation maps an initial figure to a final figure called image For example, let image of point with coordinates x, y in set A be a point with coordinates 2 minus x, y, which is a point in set A dash, that is x, y transforms to 2 minus x, y. Now, under this transformation, a point with coordinates 2 minus 1 transforms to a point with coordinates 2 minus x, y. Now, here x is 2, y is minus 1. So, coordinates of new point will be 2 minus 2, that is 0, and y, that is minus 1. Thus, this point with coordinates 0, minus 1 in set A dash is the image point of the point with coordinates 2, minus 1 in set A. Under this transformation, here the point 2 minus 1, that is the point with coordinates 2 minus 1, is called input point, and the point with coordinates 0 minus 1 is called output point. So here we can see that whenever we are given the coordinates of any figure along with the transformation rule, we can easily find the coordinates of the new image after the transformation and hence write the coordinates of the image of the given figure. Now let us discuss transformation rules for reflection. First of all, let us discuss reflection in x-axis. Now, under reflection in x-axis, the image of point A with coordinates x, y is the point A dash with coordinates x minus y. So, here we write x, y transforms to x minus y under reflection in x-axis. Now let us discuss an example. Here, when we reflect the point A with coordinates 3, 4 in x-axis, we get its image point as the point A dash with coordinates 3 minus 4. Now let us discuss reflection in y-axis. Now under reflection in y-axis, the image of the point A with coordinates x, y is A dash with coordinates minus x, y, and we write x, y transforms to minus x, y under reflection in y-axis. Now here you can see under reflection in y-axis, the image of point A with coordinates 3, 4 is the point A dash with coordinates minus 3, 4. Now let us see reflection in the line y is equal to x. Now under reflection in the line y is equal to x, the image of the point A with coordinates x, y is the point A dash with coordinates y, x, and we write x, y transforms to y, x. Now here you can see under reflection in the line y is equal to x, the image of point A with coordinates 3, 5 is the point A dash with coordinates 5, 3. Now let us see reflection in origin. Now under reflection in origin, the image of the point A with coordinates x, y is point A dash with coordinates minus x, minus y. And we write x, y transforms to minus x, minus y. Now we know that the point where the x-axis and y-axis intersect each other is called origin. Now, under reflection in origin, the image of point A with coordinates 3, 3 is point A dash with coordinates minus 3, minus 3. Now let us discuss transformation rules for translation. Now a translation of A units in horizontal direction and B units in vertical direction is a transformation of the plane such that the image of point A with coordinates xy is the point A dash with coordinates x plus A, y plus B, and we can write it as xy transforms to x plus A, y plus B. Now let us discuss an example. Here under translation, where x, y transforms to x minus 3, y plus 2, the image of the point 4 minus 3 will be x minus 3, y plus 2. Now here x is 4, y is minus 3. So image of this point will be 4 minus 3, that is 1. Minus 3 plus 2, that is minus 1. Also we must note that in a translation, if a point is moved to the right, then A is positive. And if it is moved to the left, then A is negative. Similarly, when point is moved up, then B is positive. And if it is moved down, then B is negative. Now let us discuss transformation rules for rotation. Now let us discuss rotation at angle of 90 degrees about origin. Now when image is rotated at 90 degrees angle about origin in clockwise direction, then image of point A with coordinates x, y is point A dash with coordinates y minus x. And here we write x, y transforms to y minus x. And when image is rotated at 90 degrees angle about origin in anticlockwise direction, then the image of point A with coordinates x, y is point A dash with coordinates minus y, x. And we write x, y transforms to minus yx. Now on rotation of 90 degrees angle about origin in clockwise direction, the image of point A with coordinates minus 3, minus 2 will be the point A dash with coordinates y minus x. Now here y is minus 2 and x is minus 3. So minus x will be minus of minus 3, which is 3. So image point is A dash with coordinates minus 2, 3. Similarly, the image of point A with coordinates minus 3, minus 2 on rotation of 90 degrees about origin in anticlockwise direction is the point A double dash with coordinates minus y, x. Now here y is minus 2. So minus y will be minus of minus 2, which is 2. And x is minus 3. So image point is A double dash with coordinates 2, minus 3. Now here we can see, when we have rotated the point A with coordinates minus 3, minus 2 at an angle of 90 degrees about origin in clockwise direction, then we get its image point as A dash with coordinates minus 2, 3, and when we rotated it at an angle of 90 degrees about origin in anticlockwise direction, then its image point is the point A double dash with coordinates 2, minus 3. Now let us discuss rotation at angle of 180 degrees about origin. Now when image is rotated at 180 degrees angle, now direction does not matter in this rotation, then image of a point A with coordinates x, y is the point A dash with coordinates minus x, minus y, and we write x, y transforms to minus x, minus y. For example, image of a point A with coordinates 2, 1 when rotated at 180 degrees angle about origin is point A dash with coordinates minus 2, minus 1. Now here you can see, when we rotate the point A with coordinates 2, 1 at an angle of 180 degrees about origin in anticlockwise direction, we get the image point as A dash with coordinates minus 2, minus 1. And when we rotate it at an angle of 180 degrees about origin in clockwise direction, then again we get the same point, that is the image point A dash with coordinates minus 2, minus 1. So we can see, in this rotation, direction does not matter. And now let us discuss rotation at angle of 270 degrees about origin. Now when image is rotated at 270 degrees angle about origin in clockwise direction, then image of the point A with coordinates x, y is the point A dash with coordinates minus yx, and we write xy transforms to minus yx, and when image is rotated at 270 degrees angle about origin in anticlockwise direction, then image of the point A with coordinates xy is the point A dash with coordinates y minus x, and we write xy transforms to y minus x. For example, image of point A with coordinates 2 minus 3 when we make it at an angle of 270 degrees about origin in clockwise direction will be A dash, that is the point A dash with coordinates 3, 2, and when it is rotated at an angle of 270 degrees about origin in anticlockwise direction, then its image point is the point A double dash with coordinates minus 3, minus 2. So in this session we have learned that transformation acts as a function that takes points in the plane as input and gives other points as output. And this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.